Hi everyone. I trust everybody had a good night's sleep, same as I did. So yeah, my name is Artur. Thanks for the intro, Teddy. Fabio, by the way, that was a nice talk. So yeah, I'll try to keep up. So yeah, today I'm going to talk about how Chinese companies could actually make a profit in the Western market. And I know that most of the companies are actually focused on China, but I want the purpose of this talk today, I want to show that there is a big opportunity which lies outside of China. So this is like a rough plan of what we're going to cover. I'm going to do a little introduction about myself and Playrix, and then I'm going to move over to the five steps which you need to keep in mind before going west. So yeah, like Teddy said, I've been in the industry for more than 5 years, almost 6 technically. So most of that time I spent with Creative Mobile, but right now I'm moving over to theirs. Been in the company for a while now, and mostly focusing on user acquisition and monetization as well. So let me tell you a little bit more about Playrix. So you probably know our hit games such as Township, Gardenscapes, and Fishnet. So the company is almost 500 people now, with offices in Russia and Ukraine and also Dublin. So the interesting thing about Playrix is that they actually have the company's employees actually work remotely. So they're not sitting in the offices, but they're working from their homes or other co-working options and stuff like that, so which is pretty cool. We don't have an office in Estonia, so I'm one of them. So yeah, Playrix is a top 20 grossing developer worldwide, primarily because of the hit games which we made, which were very successful, actually very successful in China as well. So yeah, that's a little bit intro about us, and I'm going to move over to my topic. So basically, I want to show you a little chart here about the mobile gaming market. So, well, not only the mobile gaming, but also the general gaming market. So, as you can see, China is like roughly $24 billion, which is a lot. But if you look closer at the chart, you probably notice that like, there's a big foreign market, which is outside of China. And this is a unique opportunity for Chinese developers to take advantage of that as well. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about that today. So yeah, if we look at the market, is growing rapidly. So we see a steady growth each year, and we do see that mobile is getting bigger and bigger. So this is one of the things which actually help developers scale their businesses by going mobile. So yeah, China actually beat US in terms of revenues last year, and I think it's going to grow definitely. But if you combine all the other countries which are in the top 10, you see that there is a lot more ground to cover. So basically, when you want to go west, first thing you need to do is actually need to set up a business abroad. It actually helps. So there are some questions which are in the head of every businessman, every developer, to be honest. Like, why do I need to go like to other markets? Where should I set up my business, and what can I get for it? So basically, to answer all these questions, like going west really gives you. Going west actually gives you like a big benefit. It gives you very good access to the market itself. So by setting up your business, let's say in Europe, you actually cover most of your time zones because like Europe is located right between US and Asia, which makes it more or less convenient to talk with business partners from all around the world and keep in mind their time preferences, which is one thing. So the second thing is, I'm just gonna give you a little overview about the countries in Europe. Unfortunately, I don't see any pictures here, but yeah. So basically, I took 4 countries as an example, one of the most popular choices that game developers usually make. I threw in Estonia as well, actually, but one of the things I'm gonna talk a little bit more about. So yeah, it's gonna be hard explaining the pictures, but anyway, so Ireland is like one number one choice, and all the big companies actually use it, such as, you know, like Apple, Google, Facebook, all the other major companies are based in Ireland for many reasons. One reason is actually the taxation policy. So Ireland has a very friendly taxation policy for all businesses, and it favors IT, so most of the businesses are attracted there primarily because of the income tax, which is very low. On a side note, when you think about Estonia, Estonia is actually more attractive in this sense because the corporate tax is zero. So basically, businesses are welcomed to Estonia, and if you have some questions about that afterwards, I can explain in more detail. So, but there are also the downsides, right? So, like, Ireland is much more preferred in terms of location because it gives much more direct access to all the big players in the market. It's easier to travel. The business value is much higher. So that is why most of the companies choose that country despite other countries' advantages. So Germany and UK are also popular choices, primarily because of the business value they give and access to industry events and stuff like that. So yeah, just to outline high level what setting up business in Europe means, this gives you direct access to the market, much more smoother regulations than in China, financial stability and ease of access, and yeah, I guess transparency, that is also one thing which is very important. So yeah, now I'm going to talk a little bit about the product itself. So well, first of all, before going live on any other market, you need to do some research, obviously, because games which are popular in China are not meant to be popular in the West, like just like that. So you need to do some research, see how your product is fit for the Western market. Maybe do some custom tailoring, because you know, one game successful in China doesn't mean it's automatically successful in the West. So you might do a little bit of research, maybe scan your audience, do some surveys. And maybe that will help you to, you know, to understand a little bit more about what are your options. Should you consider going to the West, or should you revamp the product? So yeah, in terms of metrics, mind the numbers here. I mean, like the LTV, because that is just taken out of the sky. The important thing here, I wanted to show the retention metrics, which are actually dropping. So you see that you know, retentions on the 7-day go below 10%, which kind of makes you believe that the life cycle of the game gets shorter and shorter. So you need to definitely keep that in mind before making a game. So like in China, for instance, with our games, we see that the players are very active in the first couple of days, but then they stop playing. The important thing about Western markets you should keep in mind is that their lifespan is a little bit longer and the engagement is not that high in the first days. So they take it, I would say, more easily. Whereas the Chinese players, they actually prefer to engage in the game very quickly and quickly forget about it. So you might as well tweak your balance in the game before actually going live in the West. Well, obviously UI and UX differences there are service companies which give you, like, which can help you optimize your games in terms of visuals and in terms of game psychology. So I'm not going to mention any names now, so that, like, you can ask me later if you want to. So basically, you need to change the art style a little bit, maybe the color scheme, and also if you have like cute and fluffy animals, you can also throw that in. That always helps. Here's just one example, like how a Western game competes versus Chinese game in terms of visual. Yeah, maybe like not the best example, but I was just trying to show you that, you know, for the for the West, usually considered more light graphic with less contrast, and point out other key elements of gameplay. So yeah, well, just like an overview. So localization and testing. The important thing to keep in mind is that despite the rest of the world is considered to be very, very different, it's actually not. So if you have a game which is custom fit for, like, let's say, a US person, yeah, then most likely the game will also have more or less good metrics in other regions. The only thing you should change is actually the translation to other languages, so you don't have to be bothering with any, I don't know, custom games for every country. Actually, you make one adjustment, make the game fit for a Western customer, and automatically, with a certain mindset, all people around the world can play it. They just need to translate certain things to improve your visibility. And as studies show that if you localize your assets, you usually get 70% more conversion rates, which is very good. It helps a lot. There's like tons of companies out there who do translation to 15, 20 main languages. Very easy to maintain, no big deal. Testing is important, so you should definitely consider testing your game in the countries I pointed out. So Canada, Australia, UK are always popular choices. You should test out your game and see how it performs, and then if the metrics are good, you should go global. If not, you should continue improving the game and always have a decent amount of soft test logic. And a little bit about distribution. So the important thing is that distribution in the West is much more easier than it is in China. For instance, there's only two main stores. Well, I'm not taking in Windows, there's also a Windows store, but there's Google Play and there's Apple. And pretty much that's all you need for a good start. Because you need only one set of APK files or either binary files for Apple. You upload them and they're instantly available in all countries. You collect all your revenues in a centralized way. And it's very convenient. So this allows you to improve your financial stability and ease up your distribution efforts. There's only one payment solution, and that is provided by the platforms themselves. So no need to think about, oh, what kind of payment solutions should I integrate for my payment to receive payments, because that problem is being solved by the major platforms. Tracking is obviously works a lot better in the West than in China, but I'm going to get to that a little bit later. In the marketing part, actually. So when it comes to marketing, so in the West, there's a lot of opportunities to promote the game. The situation in China is definitely different, because there are different ways of promotion here, although they are still digital and offline, and most of the promotion comes through the stores themselves. But in the West, you actually can be very successful by doing very sustainable UA campaigns, like we at Playrix do. For instance, we use almost like 100 ad providers just for the Western market, and always struggling to find more and more quality sources of traffic. So it kind of shows you the landscape that there's a lot of opportunities how you can effectively buy in the West. And the quality of the traffic is very good, because in Western Europe, and US especially, as well as Australia, the income, the people's income is significantly higher, which allows them to buy, spend more money on the games, and this helps developers get more revenues out, which allows you in the end to buy more users more effectively. So there's less fraud in the West. So as a business, it's very important, because like, you need to optimize on your campaigns constantly. I'm not saying that fraud is gone, right? But it's just less fraud in the West than it is in China. And the overall connectivity is much better. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So how to scale your marketing efforts? Basically, like I said, you have a lot of different approaches how you can buy media, mostly through ad networks, but also you can do programmatic media buying through different DSPs and other programmatic platforms. You can buy from exchanges, you can set up direct deals with other advertisers, other developers, all of them pretty much open to it. So basically, it's up to you what you want to do in the end, right? But there's definitely a lot of options. And since the competition in the West is very high, I know it's high in China as well, but since it's very high in the West, it eventually leads to better quality, and better quality results, and some of the businesses are very successful, some of the businesses are not, but that's their problem, right? So yeah, that's in a nutshell what I wanted to say. If you have any questions afterwards, I'll be there outside. So don't hesitate to ask me, and I can give you a little bit more intro about info about Estonia, about marketing, and if you have maybe something useful we can offer each other, then you just do that too. Thank you.